Hi, welcome to another episode of This Is My Architecture. I'm Jack, and I'm joined here by Aaron. How you doing, Aaron?
Doing well.
Awesome. So you've got something pretty cool laying in your hands there. You want to tell us all about it?
Absolutely. So this is a internet-connected small garden, and I got a little computer chip in there with an associated mobile application. Sends you notifications on when to water and provide you guidance on how to grow plants.
Excellent. So let's go through kind of what's inside the garden first. So what kind of AWS services do you have running in there?
Absolutely. So here on our garden inside, we're running free RTOS with a variety of Amazon libraries and SDKs inside of the garden. We use it for device provisioning as well as the device shadow service, which sends consistent state across the rest of our architecture, as well as, you know, OTA updates, jobs frameworks, that sort of thing.
Okay, and how do those kind of OTA updates, you know, how do you provide connectivity to AWS?
Yeah, absolutely. So from our garden, we connect directly to IoT Core, and we're using the, again, the device shadow here to replicate garden state. So, you know, things here, right? We've got water level that comes in. We've got relative humidity. We've got temp. Are all readings, amongst others, that come from sensors on the device. We have a variety of them, two temperatures, you know, relative humidity, water. We have an advanced water sensor there. It's taking electrical connectivity readings through the water, and all that information is being sent up to Amazon IoT Core through the device shadow.
So it sounds like you got a bunch of sensors inside of the garden itself taking these.
Yeah.
And then those get sent through IoT. So I imagine these are processed by Lambda and then sent into Pinpoint. So I imagine that's also the smarts of the garden.
Sure, absolutely. So what's really important about IoT Core for us is the ability to associate a topic rule. So we've got a topic rule here that monitors a MQTT device shadow underneath the scenes is MQTT. And so we've got a topic rule that monitors a very specific queue from MQTT associated with updates and triggers a Lambda for us.
Okay.
That Lambda is all about responding to state changes of interest from the garden. So if the water level, you know, goes down and gets really low, then, you know, we're monitoring that with a topic rule, a Lambda fires, and then it's going to go over to Pinpoint and tell Pinpoint, hey, you know, the owner of this garden, users can have many gardens, of this garden has low water, and so we need to go ahead and reach out to them and let them know that via push notification that they need to do something to address their low water, ideally fill it.
Yeah, and I've been told many times to fill my garden before. So tell us a little bit more about Pinpoint and how the internal architecture of that works.
Sure.
I imagine this couldn't have been easy.
Yeah. So, you know, adjusting behaviors for us is really important by the time you get down to the end user, because although plants are pretty hardy, right, they do require some amount of interaction from the end user. And our way to do that is through Pinpoint and push notifications. The Lambda here that listens to state changes also mixes in quite a bit of metadata from our other systems. And these are things such as, you know, the date time of when the plant was planted, the type of plant that was growing, you know, other information along those lines associated with the particular garden and the particular user. So if we were to get, you know, an update here, topic rule gets triggered, Lambda gets updated, we combine all this information on Lambda launch into a table for Pinpoint that is based on endpoint attributes. And those endpoint attributes guide Pinpoint for doing more complex workflows through journeys, campaigns, segmentations. So it's a real nice decoupling from state, which is sort of all this side, mm-hmm. and what IoT core, our firmware and everything is just sort of sitting here, updating state, updating state, updating state. And Pinpoint, when it hits a attribute of interest, say, you know, we've got a plant that's on day 10 of growth, and we know it's associated with this garden right here, then what happens is Pinpoint has created a segment off of that, and that segment then gets populated with all endpoints associated with the owner of this garden right here.
So this is kind of how, say, you know, I had a low water alert, you know, earlier this morning, so I went and filled it. And so does that make Pinpoint effectively splice off into another journey saying, you know, okay, now this user has finally watered their garden, resume this journey, that sort of thing?
Yes, absolutely. Yes. So what happens is, as you described, we get a low water notification, and as opposed to knowing that the plant is on basal day 10 here and true, instead, you know, we understand that water level is low, you know, in this part of it. We set another attribute that signifies that water level is low, and a journey can be watching a segment or get a real-time event fired and launched the same way. Again, notifying the user that they're out of water.
Gotcha. Well, you know, I'm glad this is around so my plants don't die. But I do want to know, is there anything new for Eden with Pinpoint, Lambda, and the rest of the architecture that you have here?
Sure. So what we're working on here is, this is one part of our design to, you know, encourage users to take care of their plants. But as we all know, we have days of low motivation, right? And what we want to do there is, if you're constantly ignoring our notifications here, we want to be able to then push whether or not you've taken an action, you know, check or not, and feed that back through our API gateway, associate that meta information, and then the next time through, whenever we get any sort of additional readings, these fired about every 10 minutes for our gardens, we'll notify Pinpoint, and Pinpoint can get a little bit more aggressive about how it asks you to water, or in the positive case, right, we're going to give you lots of credit for, you know, taking good care of your plants.
Well, I'm always open to positive feedback. Aaron, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching another episode of This Is My Architecture.